So a few years ago I built a wooden router lift, and it's been serving me quite well ever since. But my table saw can tilt, and so can my bandsaw, so why can't I have a router lift that tilts? So I built myself a tilting router lift, and in this video I'll show you how I came up with that design. My initial idea was to try to use trunnions to tilt a router lift, but that seemed awfully complicated, so my next approach was to use hinges, and that looked like it was much easier to build. So next I want to produce a 2D view, so I start by selecting standard views and the view from the right. And then the next thing I do is I turn off perspective off by selecting parallel projection, and I've got my 2D view. Then I hit print screen to copy that view into the clipboard. And next I run my BigPrint program and I select file, paste image to get it in here. Now I know I drew that table to be 55 centimeters wide, so I'm going to use calibrate scale by distance. Select the width of that table and enter 55 centimeters. And now BigPrint knows how big it is. Next, I'm just cropping the area of interest, and now I'm ready to print. Now I just need to glue those four pages together and I'll have an actual size printout of the router lift. So let's check that drawing. So here's one of my plastic knobs, which looks like it's about the right size. And here's the router motor. And yeah, that seems to fit on the template pretty much. So I want to make a new table saw extension and mount the router lift underneath here. So let's just take that one-to-one drawing, and that looks like it'll go under here just okay. So after that, I used my BigPrint program to make one-to-one printouts of all the parts in the router lift, and I used those as templates for cutting them out on the bandsaw. And in my next video, I'll show you how I built that router lift step by step.